One, two, three. Thanks, and welcome to Songwriters in the Round. My name is Julie Daugherty, and that's a song that I wrote for my niece's wedding this past fall. And today I'm joined by some songwriting friends from the Gloucester area. I have Fozzie Hill over here, who's a great songwriter, has been writing songs for years, and Fly Amaro, who's a legend up in Gloucester, a wonderful blues player, and Woody Woodward on bass, easy for me to say, Richie Grace on guitar and harmonica, and Steve Sadler on mandolin and some slide guitar today. We're going to start off with Playa Mero. You've been playing up in the Gloucester area and around this area for many, many years, haven't you?
Many
You must be really old, Nomo.
I'm a really old guy. You know, I can't remember the last time I can't remember when I first started playing.
Really?
So long ago.
So you've been playing since you were a little kid, knee-high to
well, a... Well, 11, I think, actually. I was around 11 when I played guitar. I used to sing songs when I was a little kid.
And you've been writing songs since you were a kid, too?
Yeah, sort of. Yeah. They weren't very good ones, though. You know, the first ones were
well,
good.
We'll be the judge of that. No. Let's hear one now. This one is... Okay. What is this one called?
This is a song called I Don't Know Where I End and You Begin, and it's been called by some people, it's been described as like the anthem for codependency relationships. I don't really know what that means. I'll just play the song.
Beautiful song.
Ooh.
Boy, that is a soulful song, boy.
Thank you.
You write a lot of songs like that, and boy, you really sang up a storm, I have to say.
You know, I write some songs. That one really sort of struck home with me. I think that was, I was in this relationship, and it was real. It was real. So
you can feel it just listening. And you can sing so well this early in the day.
I got up early this morning.
Yeah. And this is very interesting to have a left-handed guitar player on the show. I don't think we've ever had.
And this is the upside-down version.
Yeah.
This is sort of like the Albert King style. Albert played this way. He played a right-handed guitar and flipped it over. That's really what it is.
Yeah, really. Beautiful sounding.
Thank you.
We're going to turn our attention over to Fozzie. And I was thinking, the first time I met you was when we were doing the open mic at the Hawthorne Hotel.
That was a long
and
time
I was
ago.
So impressed. You had such a beautiful voice. And you've been writing for how long now? How many years?
I'm not sure when I started writing, but I've always made up songs.
Yeah, it's a very natural thing for you to do, I can tell.
Yeah.
What's this one that you're going to do for us?
This song I wrote for my dad. He died a while ago, and it was kind of fresh after he died, and it didn't take long to get it out. But it's called Still Crying. Mm. And it's hard to lose someone you love. Stand up, somebody tell me how long will I cry? 'Cause I've been walking with my head held real high, but I'm dragging my heart on a worn out and tired line. All my friends tell me it'll take good time. Time.
nice tribute to your father.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Thank you.
And we're going to turn our attention back over here to Fly. I'm going to ask you, have you always done a solo fly, or have you had bands through the years? Or?
I used to be mortally terrified of solo.
You'd never know.
Way back when I was in the 60s, my sister and I used to do, I guess you wouldn't call that solo, but it seemed like solo because it was the coffee house thing. It was like you could hear a pin drop.
Yeah. And nothing more frightening.
Yeah, it was terrifying to me. I'd much rather be I could be in a band playing in front of millions of people, and yeah, that would be a lot easier.
It is very unnerving.
So I mean, for years I was in bands. I've done a lot of bands. I've done like probably predominantly like electric guitar stuff. You know.
Yeah, because you play so well.
Last 4 or 5 years I got it.
And you have some kind of a blues jam up at the Rumline on Thursday nights, is that?
Well, yeah, the open mic, which has been going on for years and years and years. Mm. Terry Rubin ran it years ago, and I've been doing it now for a while.
Good for you.
And it's a blast.
Yeah. A lot of great songwriters in this area, isn't it amazing?
Yeah, there's a tremendous talent in the North Shore area. Mm. Tremendous talent. Mm. Goes unnoticed sometimes.
It does. And this is a beautiful song too.
This is kind of a sort of a, what you might call a Merle Haggard-esque kind of a drinking country blues to it.
Yeah. God, you can sink your teeth
how
right
early
in.
In the day is this show going to be running? This needs to be late at night. This is called Make All My Blues Go Away. Mm.
So clear that you make all my when pull-ups flow, and let the clear liquor pour, and make all my blues go away.
Now, has anybody recorded any of the songs you've written?
Me.
Besides you.
Besides me?
I mean, you sound like you should be in Nashville. That's what you sound like to me.
Well, you know, I got some friends down there. Lots of, I didn't realize how many people I knew that are in Nashville. People that have been here in the past and moved down there.
Yeah.
And I'm writing with a couple of them now. Robert Ellisoro is one. And,
wonderful. Good for you.
And yeah. Working toward that.
Yes, yes. Good job.
Thank you.
Fozzy, you have a beautiful song that we're going to all play on. I really like this one. It's called
Thanks.
This I Know.
Okay.
Yeah. I am holding your heart deep within my soul.
Well, we're going to turn our attention.
Well, I liked all the stuff that you guys did. That's awful. It's a lot of fun.
Thanks. Richie Grace is going to do a song. It's been a while since you've been a guest on this side of the camera. You've been doing the sound for most of our shows this year.
That's right.
And where is Ziggy? I miss my god dog.
Ziggy is in retirement.
In retirement?
He's resting.
In Florida.
he thinks he's in Florida.
What's this one called, Richard?
This is called The Flying Song.
As touching the universe, if you trust in your ability to fly. When doubts are there, and they will be there, when you notice that your altitude is somewhat less than high, when you're faltering and failing and falling back to earth, just trust in your ability to fly. If I were the only human, I would be perfect. Even if I wasn't, who would know? In reality, I have my share of imperfections, and they follow me everywhere I go. When doubts are there, they will be there. When you notice that your altitude is somewhat less than high, when you're faltering and failing and falling back to earth, just trust in your ability to fly. Sometimes it's easy gliding through the air, dancing with the angels high above. And other times I'm grounded, weighted down by fear, pondering the mysteries of love. Less than high, when you're faltering and failing and falling back to earth, just trust in your ability to fly. When you're faltering and failing and falling back to earth, just trust in your ability to fly. Thank you.
So how many hundreds of songs do you think you've written by now?
I don't know. More than 200, less than 5.
Oh, that narrows it right now.
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank everybody for being on the show. I'm going to do a quick switch here and hope to have you guys back on again at another time. And going to end off this particular segment of Songwriters in the Round with a little blues number. It's called When the Chips Are Down. And thanks everybody for being on the show, because my husband has no choice in the matter. And it goes like this. When the chips are down, I know you're on my side. they go. When things don't go just right, you're not running for the door. Trouble starts to brew ahead, handle it with ease. When you're doing what you're doing, you can bring me to my knees. Always count on you to be around when the chips are down. When the chips are down, you're always there.
Yeah.
When bad luck come to town, you don't disappear.
All right.
Cheers!